sweet. It's so good to be back with you again doing math. Miss Ott will still keep teaching you reading and the Bible lessons this week, but I get to do math with you, so I'm very excited. We're going to start off with our doubles wrap. I know it's kind of hard to see right now because of the lights, but you can make out the numbers. So I want you to say this with me. Do it with me. Ready, set, go. It's the doubles, baby. Let's go, let's go. It's the doubles, baby, and we start with zero. Zero plus zero equals zero. Oh, one plus one equals two. Ooh, two plus two equals four. More. Three plus three equals six. Be careful. Kicks. Four plus four equals eight. That's great. Five plus five equals ten. Again. 6 plus 6 equals 12. That's swell. 7 plus 7 equals 14. Let's lean. 8 plus 8 equals 16. Really keen. 9 plus 9 equals 18. Jelly bean. And 10 plus 10 equals 20. That's plenty. I know I went a little fast, but you know this already. My loves, what you're going to do right now is I wanted to review this with you. I'm going to take this down. And what you're going to do is grab your packet and a pencil. So please grab just a regular pencil and your packet. So right behind Monday, here's Monday, you have Moses and the Burning Bush. Miss Ott talked to you about this. You colored this so nicely. I can't wait to see your fire when your grown-up uploads your picture of your red, orange, and yellow. And right behind there is this fact paper. Now, I am not doing any of this with you because this is a test. So I took down the doubles wrap because what I want you to do is see if you can write these answers without looking at it. So you're not looking at it at home. Okay, you're not asking your mom, your dad, your granny for help. I want to see what you can do by yourself because this you just need to know. 2 plus 2 equals, you need to know. So you need to write that down. So parents, please, please don't help your child. I know it's hard because you want to help them so they do well. But this gives you an idea too and me an idea of what they can do and what they can't do. So you know how to work with them at home. And then I know what I need to focus on in my lessons. If I need to do the doubles wrap more often, this work shows me that. So please don't help them because giving them the answers actually doesn't help them. It doesn't help you or me. So let them do this alone. My loves, if you do need help, what you can use is your name tag. So if you don't know what 2 plus 2 is, start at 2 because that's what the directions say. Start at 2 and then hop 2 more. 1, 2, 4. So if you don't remember, hop on your name tag. So please pause me right now. I want you to do this right now all by yourself. You're only using your name tag. No doubles wrap. No help from your grown-up, okay? So pause me and do this. All right, my loves, what you're going to do now is you're going to push this away since you finished it. And what I would like you to grab is your whiteboard. So I want you to get your whiteboard and your marker. And if you have a tissue or maybe an old sock that you can use for your eraser if this is getting all worn off. So grab this. You see something new behind me today. Teachers, we have school too. Our school is called professional development, and so we learn new things too. And so what my school wants me to do every time I teach you a lesson is tell you what we're going to be learning. And I have been doing that, but they wanted me to write it down too. So my loves, this is our learning target. When you shoot an arrow, you want the arrow to go onto the target. That means you got exactly where you were supposed to be. So my loves, what we're going to do today is you are going to write addition, sum some more, and subtraction, sum some went away number sentences with me. And when at the end of the lesson, I'm going to ask you, did we get on target? Did we go where we were supposed to go? Did we do what we were supposed to do? Did we write sum some more number sentences and subtraction, sum some went away. So I'm going to put this right here. We're going to come back and we're going to visit that later. Okay, my loves. What I would like you to do now is take your marker off and park it. So you have nothing in your hands, your markers pulled off of the top, and you're ready to go. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to draw children standing in line. Like when you come back to school after Christmas, we're going to have to stand in line, right, to go places. We're going to draw children standing in line. So here's my story. Mrs. Bartsch called four children to join her line. What do we need to do? Yeah, we need to draw four children. So my loves, take your markers, and I want you to draw four children. So this is not art, right? So we're just going to draw four faces. Draw four faces on your whiteboard, not too big. Four, go. If you need to whisper count, you can. When you're done, park your pencil. It'd be smart to go back and double check and make sure you have four. So count underneath, touch and count underneath, make sure you have four. Okay, so Mrs. Bartsch called four children into line. You have that on your whiteboard. Then she called three more children to join her line. What do we need to do if I called three more children to join my line? We need to make a line, don't we? Because we are getting more. So this line helps us see. First, we started with this many children. Now more are coming. How many more did I say? Yeah, I want you to talk to the computer. Three more. So draw three more. Grab your marker. Whisper count. Can't count too loud. Whisper count as you make three more. Go. Park your pencil. Your marker. All right, three more children join my line. Now, I want to write a number sentence that matches this picture. Oh, boy, where do I even begin? Where do I begin even writing the number sentence? Why look at my picture, right? My picture helps me. So I count how many faces that I have first. So count with me that I drew first. Ready, set, go. One, two, three, four. So what number am I going to write? Yep, pick up your marker underneath. So if you drew your faces up here, underneath, you're gonna write your number sentence. You always start on the left side, so you're gonna write four. What sign do I need? We drew a line, that means I got more. So what sign means I got more? Plus, you got it, plus. Four plus, how many more children came to my line? Count with me, ready, go. One, two, three, so four plus. Three, what sign do I need next? Equals, that means I count them all, right? Let's touch and count them all, ready? Set, count with me, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I want you to write a, oh boy, I want you to write a seven. What I would like you to do now is read this number sentence with me. So park your marker. You're gonna touch underneath and read it with me. Ready, set, go. Four plus three equals seven. Awesome. I want you to grab your eraser. I want you to erase everything on your whiteboard in five. Then your eraser's parked. Four, nothing in your hands. Three, two, one. Did we just write an addition, a sum, some more number sentence? We did, so we're right on target, right? Okay, what I would like you to do now is listen to my story. I have eight children in my line. Whew, I have eight of them there already. Draw eight children. Whisper count as you draw. Ready? Pick up your marker. Eight children. Give you time to do that. Make sure you are drawing eight. If you're done already, go back and double check. It shouldn't take you long because we're just drawing eyes, smile, face. Double check with me. Smart mathematicians always double check. So here we go. Ready, set, go. One, two, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8. Awesome. Your marker's parked. You have nothing in your hands. Sometimes when you're at school, if children are talking in my line, when we line up and we need to go into the hallway, I'll say, oh, you need to go sit back down and try it again. Just can't be talking in my line because we can't talk in the hallway. Other classrooms are learning, right? So, two children were talking in my line. So I had to say, you have to go sit back down. So if two children left my line, if they are not there anymore, what should we do to show that they had to go sit back down? We're going to cross them off. And where do we start when we cross things off in our picture? We always start at the back. So my loves, take your marker. How many children went to sit down? Two. You got it. We're going to cross off two. Cross off two with me. Ready? Count. Set. Go. One. Two. Park your marker. I need to write a number sentence that shows what happened in my picture. So how many children did I start with? I don't remember either. Let's go back and double check. Touch and count each face that you drew. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We started with 8. So pick up your marker. You need to write crazy 8 underneath your picture that you drew. Make an S and go back home. Park your marker. What sign do I need? It cannot be a plus because we did not get more. No, there. We did not draw a line and add more. We crossed them off. So what sign means we lost some? It looks just like my hand. Minus. Say minus, minus. Good. Say minus, minus. Yeah. Say minus means we lost them. Good job. So you're going to make a minus. It's just a little line like that. That means we lost them. How many did we lose? How many did we cross off? Yeah, 2. So we're going to make a 2. 8 minus 2. What sign do I need next? 8 minus 2 equals... How many children were still in my line because they were doing exactly as they should be? Let's touch and count and find out. Park your marker. Take your finger and go whoop. Touch and count with me. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. Grab your marker. We're going to write curly number 6. Slant on down and give it a curl, my loves. Park your marker. We're going to read our number sentence together. Here we go. 8 minus 2 equals 6. Let's do it again to make sure you've got that minus word down. Ready, set, go. 8 minus 2 equals 6. Awesome. I want you to erase. And 5. Erase everything. See if you can beat me. 4, 3, 2. Nothing's in your hands. 1. And done. Awesome. Let's do one more. We just did a subtraction of some went away. Number sentence. We're meeting our learning target, aren't we? What we're learning, what we wanted to learn, where we wanted to go, we're meeting that. All right. My loves, here is the next one. I have 5 children in my line. What do we need to do? Draw 5 children quietly. Pick up your marker. Go. When you're done, park your marker. Double check, make sure you have 5. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Awesome. All right, my loves, what we're going to do next is, I'm going to tell you how many children had to go sit down. All 5. I sent 5 children back to sit down because they came to line and they were not ready to be in my line. What do I need to do if I sent 5 children away? I need to cross them off. All right, so grab your marker. We're going to start at the front. No, we're going to start at the back. I was trying to trick you. Don't let me trick you. Silly Mrs. Bart. Start at the back. We're going to cross off five. Cross them off with me. Count. Ready? Set? Go. One, two, three, four, five. You can keep your marker in your hand. Oh, is there anybody left in my line? All right, my sweets, how many children did I call into line at first? If you don't know, go back and count. Ready? Go. One, two, three, four, five. We started with five, so we're going to write a five. Make sure it does not look like a two. I've noticed that some of you are writing your numbers backwards and your fives look like this. It's not a five. I think that looks like a two or a backwards S. So be very, very careful. Make sure your five goes down first, around, and then your hat's on top. Okay, be very careful. Five. What sign do I need? I need a minus. Say minus. Minus because I lost some, so I need a minus sign. That's why my hand, I go like this. I lost them because it looks just like that minus sign, okay? How many did I lose? Yeah, touch and count with me. Ready, go. One, two, three, four, five. So what number do I need to write? I lost all five. I crossed them all off, so make another five. Good job. So five minus five equals how many children are still in my line? Yeah, what number means none? Zero. Cap your marker. Make sure you hear it snap. If you need help, ask a grown-up. Touch and count with me. We're going to read our number sentence. Ready? Go. Five minus five equals zero. Let's do that one more time. Ready? Go. Five minus five equals zero. Awesome. My loves, I want you to erase everything in five, four, three. Your whiteboard is clean. Two. Your cap snapped on. One. You can push that away. And what you're going to need now, my sweets, is your packet that I had you push away. You did your fact test all by yourself. What you're going to do now is turn to the next page. We are going to do 35A together. You need this, your crayons, and your pencil. So take out your packet, your crayons, and your pencil, and park these. All right. The first thing we always do on our papers is we write our name at the top. You got it. So I would like you to do that with your regular pencil. Remember, I'm going to use a marker. You use a pencil, write your name at the top, and then stop. Park your pencil when you're done. What number do you see here at the top of your paper? See a three and a two. If you just don't know that number, that's okay. We're gonna keep working on that. So if you don't know that number, there's a way for you to say it to help your brain go, oh yeah, I know that number. I do it like this. I say a three and a two, your turn. A three and a two, and then I go like this. Makes 32, your turn. Makes 32, one more time. A three and a two. Makes 32. Makes 32. Good job, my loves. You are going to trace your 32s twice and write it one time. I'm not even going to tell you about the chocolate chip because you know what number goes there. Okay, ready? Go. Stay on those lines. Make sure you write neatly. Don't just do it quick and sloppy to be done right away. Take your time because I do look at your handwriting. I do look at your numbers and how you make your numbers, and I do grade you on that, okay? Slow and careful. Make sure your numbers go all the way down to that bottom line. When you're done, park your pencil. We need to talk about how many tens and ones are in that last 32. So you're going to take your pencil. You're going to draw a line between the last 3 and 2. Which number's in the tens place? We always do the tens place first because it's the bigger number. 10 is bigger than 1, right? Which number's in the tens place? Now the 3, what number or what letter are we going to write on top of the 3 for tens? The letter T. You write a T above the 3. And which number's in the ones place? How many extras do we have? And we have 2, so you're going to write the letter O, because the word one starts with the letter O. Write an O above the 2. Park your pencil. Here's another part of our student-friendly learning target. Listen, we're going to get on target again. 6 girls and 4 boys rode their bikes to school. Draw a picture and write a number sentence to show the number of children who rode their bikes to school. I'm going to read it again since we have nothing in our hand, right? We just want to listen to it first. Listen one more time. 6 girls and 4 boys rode their bikes to school. What do I need to do? Yeah, I need to draw the boys and the girls, right, who rode their bikes. So if 6 girls rode their bikes to school, let's not take a long time to draw girls with all the curly hair. What letter starts G, G, girl? G, G. Yeah, G like G, golly. What I want you to do is take your pencil. You're going to make 6 G's. Let's just make uppercase G's, okay? 6 uppercase G's. Ready? Whisper count. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Park your pencil. Giving you time to finish. 6 G's. And then it says, and 4 boys. Oh, we got more. So what do we need to do? Before we draw the boys, what do we need to do if we got more? And we need to make a line. So take your pencil, draw a line after your girls. So you see, this is how many I started with. Now I'm getting more, right? Keep your pencil in your hand. It says 4 boys. B, b. What letter starts b, boy? We don't know this one yet, but I think you might know it. B, b. From math meeting. Yeah, a B. Let's make 4 uppercase B's because B, boy starts with B. So an uppercase B goes straight down top to bottom, and then it has 2 bumps. Bump, bump. That's a B. So we have 1. We need to make 4. So keep going. Here's 2, 3. Keep going. 4. Stop. You should only have 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Park your pencil. We need to write a number sentence that matches our picture to show how many children are riding their bikes. Because we don't know. We didn't count them all yet. So we started with girls. Take your finger. Let's count how many girls. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Take your pencil. On this long line, you're going to write 6 first. We had 6 girls. Keep your pencil in your hand. We drew a line, which means we got more. What sign means I got more? Yep, a plus. Make a plus sign. Looks like a little cross. 6 plus how many boys? I don't know. Let's touch and count them. Touch the boys with me. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4. What number are we going to write here? 4. Make a number 4. 6 plus 4. What sign do I need? 6 plus 4 equals, you got it, our 2 lines. Do you know what 6 plus 4 equals? Me neither. Let's count. Touch and count with me. All the girls and the boys, we're counting them all. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Good job counting. 7, 8, 9, 10. Wow, how do I write the number 10? It's a big number. There's numbers, two numbers that make the number 10.
A 1 first, and then a 0. You got it. Then it says, how many children rode their bikes to school?
How many?
10. We need to write the 10 again. If you don't have that part right here, I mark it wrong, so make sure you wrote it again. There are 10. All right, my loves, then it says for number 3, how many squares are in the first train? This is the train. Park your pencil, please. I don't know why I still have mine. Let's touch and count. How many are there? Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many squares are in the train? 5. You take your pencil on this little line right under the number 10. You are going to write a 5. Sure, it doesn't look like an S. Park your pencil. And then it says color. What I would like you to do, it said to take out your crayons. So take out your crayons. I want you to take out your purple. Take out, you have a couple purples in your crayon box. Take out your purple. How many does it say we're going to color? 5. All right, remember we're going to mark off each one as we count. So we only color 5. No more, no less. Ready? Pen, your crayon in your hand. We're going to make a line in each one. 5. Ready? Set. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're going to color all of those that have a mark. Quietly do that. Go. I love being able to see the marks in your boxes. That's how I know you watch my video too. So I can see that you follow directions perfectly. All right. You're coloring all 5, staying in the lines. Not sloppy. You don't want to do sloppy work. When you're done, just park your purple because you're going to keep using it. It says, how many are left? How many didn't we color? Yep, we colored them all, right? So there are how many left? 0. There are 0 left because we colored all of them. There are no blank ones left. So you need to take your pencil, not your crayon, your pencil, and you're going to write on this line where it says how many are left. You're going to write 0. There are not any left. Park your pencil. Now how many are we going to color? 4. Take your purple. We're going to mark off 4. Count with me. A little line in each one. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4. You're going to color those ones. Are you going to color this last one? No, no. We didn't mark that one off. Color those 4. Ready? Go. When you're done, make sure you filled in all the white space. Park your purple. And then you're gonna need your pencil. It says how many are left that you did not color. So look, how many squares that are left white that you didn't color? And just 1, so you're gonna write a 1. Park your pencil. My love, so what you're going to do is you're going to do these last 2 all by yourself. You know how to do this. So you're going to do these last 2 all by yourself. Before I tell you what to upload, let's just see if we met our target. Did we do what we said we wanted to do? We wanted to do and get to this target of writing addition, some more, and subtraction, some went away number sentences. Did we do that? Did we get our target? Yeah, we did. We practiced on our whiteboards, right? Did it right here. We wrote a some more, an addition number sentence. We did meet our target. Kiss your brain. You did a good job. My loves, what you're going to do is ask your grown-up to upload a picture of 35A and your fact test. your fact test in your packet to the blue math folder, okay? So upload this and 35A to the blue math folder. Parents, please leave all the mistakes on here. I want to see them. All right. You're going to finish these two and then upload it. Bye. I love you and I love teaching you math again. Bye, my sweets.